Today we're going to do a side-by-side comparison between the E5071C and the E5080B. Let's meet our contestants. Weighing in at about 20 kilograms, the E5071C was introduced in 2006 and has remained one of the most popular network analyzers in the industry. With frequency coverage up to 20 gigahertz and useful measurement applications like enhanced TDR, this has been the go-to for general purpose network analysis. Until now. Introducing the E5080B. At 15 kilograms, does this newcomer have what it takes to beat the champion? Let's put them to the test. Here I have a bandpass filter with a pass band around 10 gigahertz. Let's see how these two instruments measure up. Let's start with the E5071C. I'll use the buttons in the stimulus area to set up my sweep. I'll do a start frequency of 8 gigahertz, a stop frequency of 12.5 gigahertz, and I'll change the IF bandwidth to 1K hertz. Now it's time to calibrate using an eCal. When I connect the filter, the default S11 measurement shows up. I also want to see S21, so let's add another trace. So I'll go to Display, Number of Traces, and then add a second one. Now we have to allocate this trace to a different window. So I'll go here and then create two windows. Next, I'll select the new trace and assign the S21 measurement. I want to see the noise floor, so I'm going to adjust the scale of this measurement to have a reference level of -65 dB. If we enlarge this trace, we can see the noise floor is at about -85 dB here. So that's a simple S parameter measurement with the E5071C. Now for the E5080B. I'm going to go into Quick Start to set up my measurement. We'll start with S11. Here I can input the start and stop frequencies, the sweep time, and an IF bandwidth of 1K Hz. Now it's time to calibrate. We're calibrated and ready to measure. When I connect the filter, the default S11 measurement is displayed. Adding another trace is as easy as hitting this new trace button at the top of the screen. Let's change this new trace to S21. Now, to move this trace to its own window, all I have to do is hold and drag it to any side. This is actually really fun, and you can just keep dropping these wherever you want. Now we can see the noise floor is at about -95 dB. This is much better than the E5071C's noise floor at -85 dB when we did this same test, thanks to the upgraded hardware in the E5080B. Let's adjust the IF bandwidth from 1K Hz to 100K Hz. So now we're measuring 100 times faster. Our new noise floor is at about -80 dB. This is close to where we were with the E5071C with an IF bandwidth 100 times smaller than what we're using now. Let's see what happens if we change the E5071C IF bandwidth to 100K Hz. Not nearly as accurate. This measurement has a much higher noise floor. So after doing the same measurement on both instruments, the E5080B emerges as the winner of this head-to-head matchup. With its superior measurement performance and updated UI, this is the best-in-class ENA network analyzer. This is just one example of what the E5080B can do. In addition, this instrument can perform operations like spectrum analysis, pulsed RF measurements, and noise figure. To learn more about the new E5080B, visit keysight.com/find/E5080B. Thanks for watching.